Our struggles don't begin or end in November. No on the six ain't about picking and choosing. It's not a laundry list. It's not a menu. If you believe in one, you better fight for them all, because it's about our program or theirs. Leave it up to the right wing to lock you up for breathing and call it public safety. Leave it up to Democrats and liberals to say nothing while you go except see you when you get back. Maybe. It's up to our program or theirs. And the fact is that Asian, brown, and black is a type of unity we need to defeat these racist policies. So how about no on the six? A quick recap. Proposition one. A high-speed rail from here to San Francisco, but wait. Favi and Nunez just ordered 53,000 new beds for prison, so see, they don't want us going anywhere. Add on a sales tax, so your chips will stack and empty your pockets. It's already hard enough to pay the rent. Sounds like Whitey's on the moon again. Instead of $23 billion to go to L.A. to Frisco, how about we close the gap between being black and on the block with the sheriffs and the cops, with the locks and where the prison is, with the broken education and the long crack sentences, with the high bus prices and the no living wages. Let's close the gap between that, the state's debt, and reparations. Let's close the gap between Special Order 40 and amnesty. Instead of $10 billion to start, let's get free for free. Instead of getting from Crenshaw to Castro, let's get South and East LA to the polls to vote no on Prop 8. Let's get South and East LA to vote no on Prop 8 to defend our brothers, sisters, mothers, cousins, fathers whose right to love us we accept. But that same right to use the same love to love the same sex we reject, because it ain't like gay marriage hasn't been won yet. We gotta fight Prop 8, because Prop 8 just ain't an attack on gay marriage. It's an attack on our front line. Prop 8 is an attack on Bayard Rustin, gay and black, who planned the March on Washington. Prop 8 is an attack on James Baldwin, who stood up against the assassination of George Jackson. Prop 8 is an attack on the black and brown transgender soldiers who stood up in Stonewall during 69, a two-day uprise against police brutality that still plagues our community. So if you're no on the six, no on Susie Pena, no on Donovan Jackson, no on Devin Brown, no on Monica Garcia, no on Gonzalo Martinez, no on Taisha Miller, then being no on Prop 8 ain't a question. Just like women's rights ain't a question or a choice. Prop 4, parental notification. We beat it several times, can't get a vacation from these pro-life statements saying, oh, abortion is murder, but hold up. What was pro-life about being black, brown, Asian, anything but white, barefoot and pregnant during the Middle Passage, the Trail of Tears, Guadalupe Hidalgo, or any other type of murder that the white man's burden took? So what are you talking about when you say pro-life? Mujeres walking endlessly through the desert during pregnancy for a better or worse to give birth in this country is not pro-life. A child celebrating their first year of life having breathed more toxic air than I have in my 24 years of living is not pro-life. Three strikes ain't pro-life. At the bus all night ain't pro-life. So what are we really talking about? The hatred of women. Or maybe it's fear. Fear of that Harriet Tubman type autonomy, that Hippo Kim type autonomy, that SYOA 2008, we're graduating organizing sisters who every day are MTA in your face type autonomy. This is about a legacy of women of color owning rights to the body, so a parent's right to know doesn't sugarcoat the sexist logic behind all the misogynistic propositions. Block a sister's right to choose, then put the money into prisons, steal her kids, and don't leave a dime. We see the big picture, that being pro-choice means being no on 6 and 9. Dear George Runner, I was gonna write you a letter, but I thought, if you've been listening, you've known we're already winning. City Council took our lead, so did LAUSD, knowing your initiative to criminalize our peeps. Dear Henry Nicholas, let's talk about how ridiculous it is that you've been putting your bid on Prop 9 and 6 when you're being indicted for drug distribution. We've seen your work. Three strikes tearing apart our families, taking money, putting billions into prisons. The same old story hasn't changed since abolition, but we're ready. Armed with mass influence, we done stepped up our presence, armed with 10 more graduates. That's 10 people in 10 homes in 10 communities, 10 more soldiers who understand the sum of their histories. We are in it to win it. And we got a program to do it. No on the six. No on the $1 billion for prisons, on the 14-year-old adult sentences, on the denial of bail to undocumented immigrants, on the increased time for racial profiling crimes, no on the background checks for Section 8, no on all six letters of George Runner's racist last name. Yes to us. For showing up, for coming out, for our histories that never leave us, to our victories that we stand on. Our histories, our struggles don't begin or end in November, just in case anyone asks. The response is real simple. Get with the program. No on the six is the task. No on Proposition 1, the high-speed rail.
Vote no on the half-cent sales tax.
Vote no on Proposition 4.
Vote no on Prop 8.
Vote no on Prop 6.
Vote no on Prop 9.
No on the six. You're